Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, our titillating, terrific tap dancer, Soupy Sales.
In other circles, I'm known as Tommy Twinkletoes. Thank you, and thank you, Wayne Howe. Well, to finish up the week on the panel with us is a beautiful young lady who once, when was introduced to Frank Sinatra, Frank said, "Would you please welcome Gail Sheldon?"
Thank you. Again, I have the opportunity to introduce the fantastic young star of MASH, Alan Alda.
Well, thank you. And I have the pleasure of introducing a woman who is not only a talented actress and a very successful author, but also looks terrific in a black dress, which she's almost wearing, Joanna Barnes.
Chairman of our board, Mr. Larry Blyden.
Well, listen, it's been a marvelous week. Everybody's looking very elegant. Joanna is walking very carefully today.
Oh, that's because you teased me yesterday about how I walk.
I love the way you walk. I love the way you look tonight. Listen, we have two marvelous challenges for you today and a mystery guest who will stump you and baffle you. Right now, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Joe Sidoti.
Hi, Mr. Sidoti.
Where are you from, sir?
I guess from Red Bank, New Jersey.
Well, all right. If you were going to make a guess, that sounds like an educated guess. Well, Joe Sidoti has invented a training device. With it, you can learn in your living room something which you could previously learn only out of doors. We will now show what Mr. Sidoti's invention teaches you to do. And we'll start the game with Joanna Barnes.
Is this a sport?
It can be called a sport. It can be used as that.
It is in the broadest sense a recreation, however.
No, in the broadest sense, it's not a recreation.
Uh-huh.
One down and nine to go, Soupy.
Red Bank, New Jersey, that's the home of Count Basie.
That's correct.
Joe, this is an invention?
Well, it's a training device.
A training device.
Yeah.
Is it a training device that is used by humans?
Yes.
And is it something that you hold in your hand? Some part of it?
Part of it.
When you say hold it, you mean lift it up? Or?
Either in your left or your right hand, depending whether you're left-handed or right-handed.
I really don't know how to answer that, Soupy, because I don't know whether you hold it in your hand or not.
Well, ask Joe.
Part of it. It's touched, but it isn't, in fact, held up. Is that what you mean?
You're touched, and we're holding you up right now.
That's terrific, Soupy. You have a delightful sense of humor. That's $2. Gail?
You don't, and give me that back.
Gail?
This thing that it teaches, is it usually done in the snow?
No.
Okay, $3.07 to go. Alan?
I just want to make sure we haven't misdirected ourselves here. We have established that it is the activity that your device teaches is not considered to be a recreation, generally speaking.
The general field is not a recreational field, but there is within that field an aspect to this which is recreational.
Yeah, and it is fairly sportive.
Well, when it's recreational, it's sporting.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, is it something that one tends to do when one does it after he's learned on your device with, in the company of other people?
Can be.
Mm-hmm. It's something he can do alone or she can do alone.
That's correct.
Is it something that involves any kind of physical exertion?
Slight.
It's so slight as to be negligible. Four out of six to go, Joanna.
But this can be enjoyed by men and women together.
Yes.
Is this thing associated with any particular season of the year?
No.
Five down and five to go, Soupy.
Is there anything ever mechanical about this? Like you would be in your living room and you might... You learn something that might be reflected on a screen or something on in the house?
Not in that sense, I don't think. 4-6 down and 4 to go, Gale.
Now, this actual device, does some part of your body touch it?
Yes.
Would that be below the waist?
It could be.
Yeah.
It could be.
Are you standing when you're using this?
No.
7 down and 3 to go, Alan.
The activity that it trains you do outdoors.
Right.
Is any machinery involved in that?
Yes.
Does that machinery move?
Yes.
Does it have wheels?
Yes.
Is it a form of transportation?
Yes.
Is it a car?
No.
8 down and 2 to go, Joanna.
So we can rule out that this teaches you to drive. It's not a car.
As you can rule out that it teaches
you... Oh, it teaches you to fly.
That's exactly what it does. Joe Sidoti is the president of Analog Training Computers, Inc., and he's developed a personal flight simulator which teaches people to fly at home. Could we take a look at that?
Sure.
Here, Jennifer, would you bring it out, please? Here it is. That is some device. Let's go over there, Joe. First of all, I would like to ask you how much this device costs.
This costs $995. We have a more advanced model, which costs $1,800.
Now, does an individual buy this, or do institutions buy it? How does it work?
Individuals buy them. Flying clubs buy them. Schools are buying them. As a matter of fact, one of the most important uses we found is coming about is that schools are finding this is an excellent way of motivating students, keeping them from dropping out. It encourages them to take the sciences, mathematics, physics, and so on.
That's marvelous. Now, how does it work? Can I try?
Sure.
Okay. What do you do?
I have to switch on. This indicates that you are flying. This right here is the artificial horizon. What you see there is a miniature airplane, and you're turning the wheel and closing the background to turn in response.
I see. What is the object? What do you try to do to keep...
When you fly an airplane, you must...
Well, look, it moves up and down.
Yes, that's indicating that the airplane is pitching up or pitching down. And, of course, when you pitch down... You'll notice that you'll see that this will descend, showing that the altimeter is showing that you are descending.
Mm-hmm. You have one that shows when you hit the ground?
You'll hear a buzzer. We have a buzzer on
it. A buzzer.
And it segues into a harp.
Right. And as you pull back long and far enough, you'll notice that the airspeed drops off so low that it stalls. And stall in the aircraft means the aircraft has stopped flying. The red light indicates that, and now you're in a spin. You'll notice that this is spinning about.
Oh.
You're now inverted upside down and continuing around, coming out the other side.
Joe, we're falling!
This is the compass up here.
Yeah.
And down below this, you'll see down here is the directional gyro, which is actually an indication for heading. And these two needles here indicate the theoretical course which you must follow in order to get the airplane down on the ground when you're flying. The needle that is pointing up at this time indicates that you are below the altitude you should be at in order to make an approach. This needle indicates that you are to the right of the course that you should be at to make an approach. You'll never find the airport.
Larry,
Joe, you can't send a kid like me up in a crate like this. Now what's happening?
I'm turning it back right side up.
I thought something was wrong.
We also have a device here which causes turbulence to be injected, which creates the same characteristic that you would see if you were flying and you were totally enclosed by clouds. And, of course, if you want to climb, you add power and pull back on the wheel and try to keep the wings level.
Now, do you have a little thing that comes on at some point and says, the Lord is my shepherd?
No. But we have the voice of the controller, which is considered to be the same. And now you follow what the instructions are.
Good to the approach, ILS runway 7. Approach 124.3, A2 Bravo.
And this not only teaches them how to fly, but also listen to the transmission and how to respond.
Bravo, 2 from the marker.
Now, on the large unit, are there also pedals that you can use?
Yes.
This particular, report the marker, A2 Bravo.
He's just asked the pilot to report at the marker, which means at this point, when this blue light comes on, you're a theoretical 7 miles from the end of the runway, and at that point, you start to make a letdown. And when you... Please try to keep the wings level.
I'm doing my best. It's this turbulence that's got me. This is really a fantastic thing, and the use for children in educational situations is really marvelous.
Thanks.
Congratulations. It's a great contribution.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this one.